I tried, I really did, but there was something not quite right with GhostBSD running on my test machine. That didn't happen with any other Linux or BSD distro. Simple screen recorder on GhostBSD didn't work. It made the computer freeze to the point where the review is split, and each segment is strangely the same length. Could be a memory leak, or just a bad package, but it was a showstopper for me. What a shame. Maybe if I'd run it in a virtual machine, maybe things would have gone smooth. But I don't like to do reviews like that. I prefer real hardware. Right, this particular review that I'm going to do is of GhostBSD 11.1. It's going to be in a style that I don't normally do. I'm going to approach it from the style of a typical Linux reviewer who's testing out a Linux distribution that he doesn't know, that he hasn't used before. So, although I don't do these particular type of reviews, I find them irritating and very shallow, I'm going to do one for this, just as an exercise. For myself, really. So, here we are with a relatively low resolution desktop. So, this is how GhostBSD has presented itself. And it's GhostBSD Mate Edition. There's a standard Mate desktop with four virtual desktops available. A simple screen recorder is running, which is very nice. Which I had to add, but I'll show you how to do that in a minute. Everything pretty much configured itself, the Ethernet. The screen resolution is a little bit low. And this is running on my test machine, which I'll give you the specs for on screen in a minute. For those who like to jiggle and pokery with the theming and how it looks, which I usually don't, but you know, I'm going to go for it in the style. There are plenty of backgrounds available. Look at all these pretty wallpapers. Wonderful. There's a usual set. There's one or two GhostBSD specific ones, like this one, which is the pretty much the standard one. If you go onto the fonts tab, you can change the fonts and the way they look for the LCDs. Fonts are quite large, but that's the default. And we'll change the theme has already been changed to traditional, okay. Which I prefer anyway. So that's the theming. It's wonderful. The system comes with quite a few already pre-configured, pre-installed packages. The Office ones and graphics ones are all pretty much standard as what you'd expect on any Linux distribution. I've installed one or two extra ones, but we'll go from here. In the you got the accessories menu, submenu. You got education, graphics, internet, office, programming, sound and video, and system tools. You got a places folder. You got your home, desktop, computer, network, connector server, which is just a fancy way of connecting via Samba or SSH. The Mate search tool and recent documents. So there's quite a few there now. Clear all recent. There you go, if you want to get rid of them. And then your system folder, which has got your preferences, and then your hardware, displays, keyboard, network proxy, look and feel, which covers appearance, main menu, pop up notification, screensaver. Station tweak, Windows, authorizations, personal, about me, and yeah, if you want them. Your startup applications is an interesting option where you can tell what to start up when your desktop starts up. And yeah, it's got pulse audio, which I don't like. Right, so in your accessories, you got your character map, you and Grandpa. Archive Manager, GVim, Mautier calculator, font viewer, search tool, which was also available somewhere. Where do else we see that? On that one. So it's there's a slight amount of duplication there, I think. Where was it? Well, I thought I saw it. And Plank, which is it's actually a cool little program. Pluma, root terminal, take a screenshot, Vim, XFBurn. Education, you got LibreOffice Math. In graphics, you got I Have Made, LibreOffice Draw, Color Selection, and Shotwell. Firefox web browser. We'll see what version that is, because there are people like to know these things. It's not your current original version. Yeah, go on then, might as well. So yeah, let's have a look. What version is this now? Let me tell you. About Firefox, 59.02. Right, we're back after a good 7 minutes while we waited for the database to upgrade, to update. Absolutely, I don't know. I'm not used to waiting that long for it, but we'll see. I mean, it's part and parcel of what's happening with this particular review that I'm doing on this. The screen resolution is out of whack. It didn't pick up on the network printer. The sound, I can't increase it. So there's just three things which immediately jumped to me. I can fix these things. But the whole point of GhostBSD is if it was to appeal to new users. I have a to Linux or from Linux to BSD. In either case, I think it's failing in its object, but what I would say. Right, so it's finished. So what do you do? How do you install a program on GhostBSD? Well, I'm not a big user of OctoPKG or any kind of graphical package manager. But I would say if it's just like Synaptic, then it's been updated. The database has been synced. So, yeah, okay. Files, transactions, output, okay. Enter your search and press enter. Okay, let's have a look. Say, for instance, CMonkey. I use CMonkey rather than Firefox. I just prefer its interface. So it comes up with CMonkey. That's actually quite fast. To install it, you right click and select install. Rather than doing it immediately, it holds it in a kind of like a to-do list along with all the other ones that you want. So let's say, for instance, I want Mock Music on Console. There it is. Again, install. It goes down there, look below that. So it will install in that order. And one more would be, is GIMP on? Graphics, not video. No, there's actually no GIMP, so let's put GIMP on there. I am really surprised that GIMP wasn't installed, but okay. Put GIMP, and yeah, okay, we'll just put the meta port in. Alright, so we'll just go ahead with these three installations. confirm, yep. And it'll just do its magic. Grant the permission without asking for password. I'm not sure about that. Okay, I'm not sure about running without needing to input it, but there you go, that's what they've chosen to go with on this. It's quite quick. Usually, on FreeBSD, the ports can be quite quick to install, but the package servers are they're not the fastest. They're not as numerous as the different ports that you can use, but the packages are a little bit slower. Is it all done? Fantastic! That's actually quite quick. That's quite impressive. So it's done. So once you've done that, then exit out and we'll see if it's installed it automatically. Yeah, there's GIMP. Look, there we go. Yeah. So I'm actually quite impressed by that. I don't use graphic package managers, but that one's pretty cool. I can't get over the last memory use of Simple Screen Roger. I do know that it's system intensive, but well, let's go to the single fit window. There we go, that's better. And we'll go to see how much memory we're using. Okay. See, now that's just weird, because now, having restarted system, having restarted Simple Screen Recorder because of that long gap, and with GIMP running, I'm only using 1.6 gigabytes. So yeah, it's kind of weird. The system is telling me at the top there that there are updates available. Let's have a look. And it will. What I do like it and I don't like it. I like to be in full control of when I'm updating the system. You know, you can do PKG update or FreeBSD update fetch, or if you want to update the parts tree. So you have three different ways of doing it, but all them different ways give you full details of what's happening. With this one, it tells you there's a FreeBSD update 11 up to patch 9, but then also tells you there's updated software. So then, which tells you that, but it doesn't tell you about that. Okay, so we'll update and it'll fetch it. So then, yeah, obviously you can see the CPU history. That's really odd. Really odd why that memory usage was so high on that first run of Simple Screen Recorder. That absolutely slowed everything down, and it was swapping like I've not seen for years. Okay.